You may have heard that some doctors recommend removal of blocked fallopian tubes prior to embryo transfer to improve first-time IVF success. Is this something you should consider? Getting pregnant with IVF requires a lot of things to be perfect. For starters, you have to have a healthy, normal embryo, and the uterine lining has to be at the right stage of development. But there could be other things that interfere with pregnancy. For example, if there is fluid in the uterus at the time of the transfer or shortly after. IVF experts have known for a long time that when it comes time to put an embryo into the uterus, fluid in the uterine cavity will lower the chances of success. In some cases, the cause for fluid in the uterine cavity is not known. In other cases, however, fluid in the cavity can be the result of blocked fallopian tubes. This is important because fallopian tube blockage is a common reason why couples need to do IVF in the first place. There are two categories of blocked fallopian tubes. Proximal blockage occurs when the tubes are blocked right where they attach to the uterus. Distal blockage is a block that occurs at the far end of the fallopian tube. Distal blockage is the kind that can result in fluid in the uterine cavity. You see, the tubes normally produce fluid that can escape out the end. But if the end is blocked, that fluid can accumulate inside the tube and eventually leak into the uterine cavity. This is known as a hydrosalpinx. This has a dramatic impact on pregnancy rates. Women with hydrosalpinx have a 50% lower chance for pregnancy compared to women without. So, how do you know if you have a hydrosalpinx? There are three methods. Ultrasound can sometimes find a swollen, fluid-filled fallopian tube. An X-ray test called a hysterosalpingogram is an excellent, non-invasive way to find a hydrosalpinx. And a surgical procedure, such as a laparoscopy, is invasive, but is also an accurate way to find a hydrosalpinx. At IVF1, we recommend that all women who are going to be treated with IVF should be assessed for hydrosalpinx. If found, then we recommend that she have her fallopian tubes surgically removed before attempting to have an embryo transfer. However, women who do not have hydrosalpinx will not benefit from fallopian tube removal. But there are other things you can do. Make sure you check out this playlist for more first-time IVF success tips. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Have a question? Leave it in the comments below. Click the link in the description to become a new patient, or just subscribe to get new episodes weekly. It's like having an infertility specialist in your phone.